Dear clients, I'm Richard, dealing manager from Phillips CFD. All the three major US equity benchmarks retreated slightly last week and broke a three-week winning streak amid rate hike chatters as well as other macro concerns, particularly a resurgence of Brexit worries and ECB taper talks. It is not noteworthy that as the market gradually readies itself for the possibility of a year-end rate hike, the banking sector, being a potential beneficiary, seems to be displaying steady performance in the recent weeks, whereas yield-chase sectors such as utilities sectors appears to be rolling over under the weight of an increased likelihood of a higher yielding environment. In terms of economic calendar, despite the headline miss in non-farm payroll, employment details were encouraging as last Friday's data revealed decent wage and working hours growth trends. Other economic data were generally instilling market confidence too. For instance, both ISM Manufacturing and ISM Service September releases were a 180 degrees reversal from the prior month's big misses, therefore allaying concern of a sharp economic slowdown. From the cross-market perspective, there were noticeable sell-offs in gold, US 10-year Treasury in recent weeks, amid a strong dollar and heightened rate hike prospects. Nonetheless, US equity market appears calm, as reflected in VIX, the equity fear barometer, which ranged in the 12 to 15 region. Looking ahead, market will likely take a break from macro watching and focus on US 3Q16 earnings season, which Alcoa unofficially kicks off on 11th of October. According to FactSet, analysts expect a 2% earnings decline for the S&P 500 companies, which will mark the sixth consecutive contraction. Investors should be closely monitoring the reporting season for management forward guidance and whether the Street has once again lowered the hurdle enough to generate positive earnings surprises. Clients may consider using Phillips CFD and Phillips ETF to capitalize on global trading opportunities in both rising as well as falling markets. This is all for today and hope to see you again in our next round market commentary. Thanks for watching.